During the reign of Song Emperor Gaozong, there was an important duel between two famous warriors at the foot of Cowhead Mountain. Wanyan Jin Chanza, son of a Jurchen prince, wielded a pair of golden hammers, and Yue Yun, son of a Chinese military general, Yue Fei, fought with silver hammers. Wanyan represented the Jin Dynasty, and Yue Yun the Song. Wanyan had previously defeated several famous Chinese warriors, so Yue Yun was being very courageous in accepting the challenge. The duel was described in the novel, The Tale of General Yue Fei, but there is no historical account to support it, even though Yue Yun was a real historical figure. According to the history of Song, Yue Yun was a brave warrior who fought with a pair of iron hammers that weighed 20 kilos each and led in battle. The hammer is one of the oldest weapons in the world. Hammer weapons first appeared in China in the spring and autumn period. The hammer works by amplifying the force of the person wielding it. Hammers were more powerful than maces and more destructive than sabers and swords against armored enemies.
People
wonder if Yue Yun's two hammers really weighed 24 kilograms apiece, as the story claims, or if this was an exaggeration. Zhu Lu Yu has been a professional badminton player, and he's in excellent physical shape. He's going to test the so-called Yue Yun hammers. Before the test, we're going to measure his upper limb strength with this device. Bai Meng Chen, editor of the Weapon magazine, explains that when he pulls on it, the readout will accurately indicate his arm strength, which will serve as a reference for later tests.
57公斤，这是我的恨不得是1.5倍的样子。我这个当然力量应该不算大，但是估计是普通人的水平。由于这位运动员呢，他经常锻炼，他肌肉比我们普通人都要发达，哎，无论是拉力、打击力、挥动力，都比我们普通人都要大得多。
Zhu Lu Yu is wearing a Song Dynasty suit of armor while trying to wield two 24-kilo silver hammers for the test. Heavy armor and weapons would be a powerful combination on the battlefield, but it's not for certain that such a combination ever actually appeared on an ancient battlefield.
现在我们想测你一下心率，运动前的心率。 我们现在用这个简易器材呢，
A martial arts coach is now running through some fundamental hammer techniques for Zhu Lu Yu. While he is doing this, we're monitoring his breathing, heart rate, and blood pressure.
我觉得如果古代的将军真的是拿这么沉的锤子去上战场跟人拼杀的话，我觉得那是不现实的。我看一下，现在心率是150次，增加了90次，就是他本人最大强度的50%。后来几下就那种有点坚持不住，格挂的动作他已经坚持不住了。
如果用于这个实战呢，是不行的。这个你到抡起来的速度就不够了。
It looks as though the weight of Yue Yun's hammers was exaggerated in the story. What would be a more reasonable weight for this weapon?
按宋代呢，实际上当时的打击兵器不止锤一种，但是如果按照他当时的双手兵器，那么双剑、双锏、双鞭、双锤。
Yue Yun chose to use hammers, not only because he was strong enough, but also because they were effective against armor. The armor of the Jin cavalry was so fearsome that the Song soldiers called them Iron Towers. These armor scales were excavated from tombs of the Tangut Empire and are housed in the Ningxia Museum. The scales were very well made. They were most likely made using a cold forging technique. What did Tangut armor look like, and how effective was it? Jiang Fun, an expert in the recreation of ancient armor, is going to replicate the famous Iron Tower armor of over 1,000 years ago. Cold forging, known today as cold rolling, made the surface of the metal harder. Soon after its emergence, cold forged armor became common equipment for cavalry. The Jurchen Iron Towers became a nightmare for the Song army because their superior armor gave them a huge advantage. According to the Song dynasty, Wu Jing Zong Yao, known in English as the complete essentials for the military classics, great progress was made in the design and production of weaponry for foot soldiers during the Song Dynasty. There were a dozen or so types of sabers alone.
宋代刀剑呢，从工艺来说呢，当时流行这个加钢，所以那个时候弯刀就比较多了。那么从形制来说呢，由于对手穿的这个非常厚重的冷锻甲，那么宋代的刀剑的形制呢就变得又短又宽又重。相对于这个宋代前后都有巨大的不同。
Zhou Zhengwu, an expert swordmaker, is going to replicate a Song Dynasty weapon. This saber, with its short handle, wide blade, and sharp edge, was one of the most important weapons in the Song Dynasty. Historical accounts indicate that this type of saber could cut or penetrate heavy armor, making it a warrior's first choice for close combat. Zhou Zhongwu is going to personally test its power to see if it lives up to its reputation. Now we're going to see how a replicated ancient suit of armor stands up against a replicated saber to see if the armor is as tough as reported in ancient sources.
这猪肉这些组织上呢没有砍痕，没有损伤，属于这个刀根本就没砍进去，
对，没砍进去。但是那个刀啊，确实很锋利，已经把这个甲片有很明显的这种刀砍的损伤有，这种绳子全是被刀砍断的。所以这个砍断了以后，这个甲片就掉下来了。
但是实际上，你看，如果在战场上这一下下来，这两个空隙啊，如果说下一次再命中的话，才有戏。
The test shows that cold forged armor provides effective protection for the wearer. Invented by blacksmiths of the Tangut Empire, gave a big advantage to their cavalry soldiers. It was not only effective, but also lighter than other types of armor. These factors made the Jin army a powerful enemy for the Song Empire.
实际上呢，这个金国军队的兴起非常快，他用30年就基本上打掉了辽，而且打掉了北宋。那么这个铁浮屠还有拐子马这种战术呢，在他的前30年发挥了。 重要的作用，取得了整个的北方黄河流域。那么最大的一仗呢，是在陕西的富平大战。这个宋和这个金呢，都投入了自己基本上全部的精锐。但是富平大战的结果呢，就是宋军功亏一篑，在富平败退了以后，丢掉了整个陕西。那么可以说，这是铁浮屠最辉煌的时刻了。The
Song brought back weapons from the past to counter the armored cavalries of the Jin Dynasty. Weapons such as the hammers used by Yue Yun were effective in directly smashing armor by force. In the Battle of Yingcheng, Yue Yun and his troops broke through the Jin cavalry, leaving a bloody trail of soldiers and horses. After the battle, Wu Zhu, leader of the Jin army, allegedly complimented the power of Yue's army. These two hammers, in the hands of Zhu Lu Yu, weigh 3 kilograms each. Based on historical references and opinions of sports doctors, this is more likely than the 40 kilograms mentioned in the story. The testing group is confident that the data they generate will more accurately reflect the situation of ancient battles and show the true effectiveness of the hammers.
它的动能应该是在133.65焦耳，
大概汉弩一般是50焦耳，因为这个动能数不算太大，说实话不算太大。
跟现在的一些
对现在的这些火器很多能到几千焦、7000焦啊、8000焦这都有。那么子弹的动能是这样的，但是你说这个东西到底有什么样的效果，还真不好说。
The kinetic energy of the hammers is not particularly impressive, but it must have been effective on the battlefield. Warriors engaged in close combat usually aim for the torso, which is the easiest to hit, or head of their enemy. These were probably the main targets for hammers. Helmet may be better than no protection at all, but is no match for a hammer. Next, Zhu Lu Yu is going to strike the target, protected by cold forged armor, to see how it stands up to blows from the hammer. Some of the armor's scales were a little bent out of shape, but there was no other damage. The question is, what would such a blow do to the wearer?
The 明显的就有两处张开了，
这个动能向里边传导，
这
个造成的损伤就是外轻内重，这要内脏存在的情况下，
比如
我的营养，肝脾破裂，这
肯定最轻的，
都可能造成。
所以呢，就是它对于这种钝器的这种打击，防护相对来说要比较差。
Because of their effectiveness, a variety of blunt weapons was developed in the Song Dynasty. These included axes, maces, hammers, and cudgels, as well as 8 types of hammers used in pairs.
The 实际上最大的爱好者是北方的游牧民族，因为游牧民族最早的时候他们的工艺比较差，如果让他们生产这个刀剑呢，难度非常大。但是生产这种棍棒、箍朵和这个鞭锏一类的兵器，粗笨一点呢，生产很容易，所以他们酷爱用这个打击兵器在马上做短兵器，也有成本和这个生产的原因。
A popular Song folk song reflected people's fear of Jurchen blunt weapons. The lyrics included the line, "The Jin has maces, and the Song has skulls."This is a recreation of the wolf fang cudgel. It weighs 18 kilograms and is basically a mace with a metal head and spikes shaped like wolf fangs. We will have to put the weapon to the test to determine if the wolf fangs were merely decorative or if they were really effective. Zhu Lu Yu will strike the target with the cudgel as he approaches it at 30 kilometers per hour, riding a battering ram.
咱这个腰椎呢，这么一撅，那肯定要骨折了。骨折脱位也会造成这个腰椎的损伤，丧失战斗力了。哎，丧失战斗力那是肯定的了，起码他瘫了。最要命的，当时啊，应该死亡的还是应该在胸部。哦，
打进去了。
嗯，这个打进一下造成心脏的损伤、肺部损伤、多发性肋骨骨折、呼吸困难，应该死到这上了。
这证明这个东西在马上借助马的这个强大的这个冲力之后，就是说能够造成的伤害确实比我们想象中要大。UAU achieved one victory after another in battles against the Jin army. Unfortunately, dirty politics in the court when he was just 23 led to his and his father's execution. His father was Yue Fei, Marshal of the Song army, who was respected by the people but persecuted by those who feared and envied him. After the Mongols became more powerful and firearms became common, blunt weapons and armored cavalries were made obsolete. In the late 16th century, when General Qi Ji Guang battled Japanese pirates, two weapons were in confrontation. One was the wolf brush, and the other was the Japanese saber. Tune in for part 10, The Wolf Brush and the Japanese Saber.